Round about an hour and a half ago, all looking relaxed. That man there stopping for an autograph, Joe Allen. And as we get to team news in just a moment, he is the big story of the afternoon. Are we going to get a goal? That would be the other big story of the afternoon. Swansea City now 5 whole games without scoring. The last time they failed to score in 6 successive games in the Football League, well, that was February 1996. So we've got to go back quite some time for it to happen. We are hoping that that statistic of not scoring is smashed out of the water, and early on as well. There'd be nothing like an early goal this afternoon to settle the Swansea nerves. Let's have a look at the team news then for Swansea City, and I've pretty much told you what I'm about to tell you. Joe Allen, we saw him getting off the bus. He comes into the Swansea City starting lineup for this afternoon's game, his first league start of the campaign, and he is in place of Liam Cullen, who's featured on the Swansea City website and media throughout the week extensively because he signed that new long-term contract. Delighted to have Liam extend his run. Incredibly, if he completes his full contract that he signed this week, he'd be at the club for 21 years by the time it completes, having joined, of course, as an 8-year-old. The Swans in their purple kit this afternoon. I think some will call it lilac or some other shade, but make your own choice. Oxford, as you would expect, as home team, yellow, blue and yellow from the top down. Formalities then before the team. We'll run through the full lineup in a moment. Formalities, and then of course a reminder that these games are ahead of these games. A number of remembrance matters to be dealt with. Oxford United, let's do their team first. In goal, they have Jamie coming, and then as they filter out 4-1-4-1, the first of those ones, number 6, Josh McEachran, a player who made 4 appearances for Swansea City back in 2012 in the Premier League days, came on loan to what was then the Liberty Stadium from Chelsea. And that was one of 5 loan spells that he had from the Blues. There's your Swansea City lineup. Just that one change. Joe Allen in for Liam Cullen, who's amongst the substitutes. It means Vigouroux in goal. Tymon Darling, Cabango and Key across the back line. Grimes and Franco in the middle. Pierre Harris and Ronald providing width with Joe Allen and Vipotnik down the centre. Cyrus Christie included amongst the Swansea City substitutes this afternoon, back on a deal till the end of the season. Takes a place on the bench alongside John McLaughlin, Florian Biancini, Liam Cullen, Choa On, Kyle Norton, Nelson Abbey, Azeem Abdullahi, and also appearing for the first time this season on either the 11 or the bench is Amir Govia. As I say, Remembrance Weekend coming up in the UK, and clubs all around the country have games allocated to that. Swansea's will be the home game on Tuesday night with Watford, but for Oxford United, it's this one here with Swansea City, and we will fall silent with the crowd.
Poppy Reese on the pitch this afternoon. We're also honoured to be joined by members of the Oxfordshire County branch of the Royal British Legion. They are on the pitch today: Fiona Lovesey, Chris Wisbrook, Jackie Graves, Sherrick Andrews, and Peter Clark. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn them. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We kindly ask you to stand and join in a period of silence.
There you go. A number of shots in that moment or two of remembrance of the travelling Swansea City supporters. We're hoping we're going to see plenty more shots of those celebrating throughout the afternoon as we look to effectively restart the season. It's been a difficult last half dozen games or so. Swansea coming into this one in 17th place on 13 points. Oxford United promoted last season. They have a point more than Swansea City. They've 3 wins, 5 draws. Swansea 3 wins and 4 draws. In terms of the chances of some goals this afternoon, well, Oxford have scored 15 and conceded 15. Swansea have scored 8 and conceded 8. Make of that what you will. When I talk about different ways of working this week, different things tried in training to try and get over this hurdle, there were chances created in the scoreless draw against Millwall last weekend. That man, Xander Potnik, certainly will hope to be amongst the opportunities this afternoon. Had a blistering drive early on in the first half last week, showing real promise, forced a good save. Didn't really get many more chances after that. Away tickets. Swansea fans, you see them on your camera shot to the top left before this ball moved downfield. Those away tickets were snapped up pretty quickly. First touches to Piet Harris, and the Brentford man holding it on the touchline. Included in the Oxford side this afternoon, their number 9, the Welsh international Mark Harris, born in Swansea, 25 years of age. Never played for the club. He was a youth player at Cardiff City. Loan spells at Newport and Wrexham. but never completed all four by playing for his home town club. Grimes, nice little run, and continues the run and moves forward into space, comes inside nicely, twisting and turning Matt Grimes and causing a few problems. That's a lovely ball through to Josh Key, and it's a low cross. It's a comfortable first gathering for Jamie Cumming. Nice bit of football by Luke Williams' men, and Matt Grimes right at the heart of it. Maybe the arrival into the starting 11 of Joe Allen will allow Grimes a little bit more freedom. As we see, Allen at the moment is the more advanced of the two. Second poor touch by Harry Darling this afternoon. 2 minutes gone. The first header went into touch, and that one just pinged off as well. It's a difficult ground to play at. You will have already noticed behind one goal there's absolutely nothing other than a few boards and a car park. And that allows the wind to go across the Kassam Stadium pitch perhaps a little more than it would in other venues. Huge gaps there as well, as you see in the top corner between the stands. It's very much three separate stands around the pitch. Now then, ball down to Godrum. Godrum can't find his way past Key. Leaves the ball for Cameron Brown to throw in, cleared away. Usual reminder that the Swansea City website Match Centre is the place for live stats throughout the game. You may be content to just know possession stats for teams. If you are, I can tell you Swansea have had 74% so far. You may want how many shots there have been, how many tackles, or you may want to whittle it down to a little more detail and go into individual players, which you can do as well. This man Grimes has already had a number of touches. He's about to get another one. I was hoping to get another one. Ronald couldn't flick it on to him. Wilson back to Moore and across the field to Kioso. Kioso can't get down the line. The ball's already out of play before there was any contact and any suggestion of a foul. Referee this afternoon is Michael Salisbury. Just two away games so far for him. Both of them in the cup, and both of them in 2021. season, one of them just into 2022. We beat Stevenage Borough in the FA Cup third round, and then we went to Brighton in the EFL Cup third round. Lost that one by 2-0. as expected. Swansea get a grip on the possession early on. 7 minutes gone. It's just a little over enthusiastic, the referee says. Not sure what else he could do there. He had to try and battle his way through. Space left, but Simon reacted quickly, saw the danger, and he set Swansea City on their way. Pete Harris into Joe Allen, looks to try and make things happen. Josh Key, central position for him. Tried to get it out to Franco, who then taken up the position on the right-hand side. Oxford coming into this game on the back of a 2-0 win at Sunderland, a 2-0 defeat at Sunderland. They have to go back to the 14th of September for their last win, a 1-0 win at the Kassam Stadium against Stoke City. Since then they've drawn at this ground against Burnley, drawn with West Bromwich Albion, drawn with Derby County, and they find themselves here today drawing with Swansea City. No doubt that their ambitions at the start of the season would be to consolidate their position in the championship table. Managed by Des Buckingham these days. Let's see how he set up his team to defend us. Swansea go probing on the left hand side, and it's the first corner of the game. Amongst those back defending, Swansea take it short. It's going to go into the centre to Grimes. Hits it first time, and it took a deflection. Well, there was an offside anyway. I think Grimes felt that it was on its way in. Let's have a little look again, maybe a different angle. Try and get one for you from behind the goal. To just show you how on target that effort was. First chance of the afternoon, though, real clear chance set up by Joe Allen, squaring the short corner. Been criticism of Matt Grimes of late being in a position like he is now as the most far back player between the two centre halves, Darling and Cabango, but this afternoon in the opening 11 minutes he's shown that he's not tied to that position, and he's got forward to a couple of really good opportunities. Mackey in a more central position again, taken down, free kick. Probably two free kicks in it. Joski just feeling the effects as he walks away. It's going to have to be something special to beat the keeper from here. It's a long way out. Timon looks as though he fancies his chances though. Grimes lifts it. If they practiced that this week, somebody forgot what the plan was. Harris, right-footed. Opens things up a little bit on the right-hand side, low ball in, Darling deals rather comfortably with it, clears it away. Chioso touches it, it's played across to Brown. A challenge on Brown when the ball goes out. Brian Harley it is that picks it up. As I say, the home side have conceded 15 goals this season. This one's you need to capitalise on. Any uneasy feelings they may have about going a goal behind. Swans, of course, have to get to that position to be a goal up. Something that's eluded them for quite some time now. Got a throw in halfway inside the home side's half. Stoke City, last team to lose at the Kassam Stadium, but they are leading this afternoon 1-0 against Oxford, one of three games kicking off at 12:30. The other one has a goal as well. It's Blackburn 0, Sheffield United 1. Sheffield Wednesday play at 3 o'clock against Watford. Swansea to the byline. And it's a corner. It has having a little success in that wide left roll. Swansea already getting round the back on both sides. In it comes Darling. Well, he got the contact and he was unchallenged. Franco plays it off Kieran Brown for a third corner. First time we've had one over on this near side. Harry Darling, look at that, he's just got away. And just didn't get his head onto it properly. He'll get another go. Flick on, oh, against the crossbar. Well, it looks like they've done some extra work this week on set pieces, because they've tried different things on each one of them this afternoon. Everybody advanced to the rather crowded near post area. There was a flick on and it's against the crossbar and played away. Boos for Vigaru, the former Swindon Town keeper. Hopefully making it clear he wanted to give the advantage. Let's see the corner again. It's Piet Harris that tries to direct it. Looks calm and composed and knew exactly where he wanted to place it. And he was inches away from his first Swansea City goal. Apart from the obvious, can't have too many complaints so far, Luke Williams. Here they come again, having hit the crossbar, having had Darling's glanced header. Decent ball in, whipped in. There's a lot of pace on it, and Ronaldo on the far side couldn't react quick enough. Shifting, wasn't it? Once it hit the deck, it spun up, took it away from the Brazilian. Buckingham's side have barely been in the Swansea final third. Surely we're going to see the flag go up there. Yes, took a little bit of time. Derek Eaton over on the far side. Fairly regular these days on the assistance role in Swansea City games. As is Simon Long, who's carrying the flag on the near side. To his arms. Putting pressure on coming. His head up, puts a decent ball in, but for the intervention that was going straight through to Vipotnik. Josh Key out muscled but unfairly. Exeter man puts the ball into the box. Swansea have good numbers forward. Shot from distance, Franco flashes it wide left foot. Certainly worth a go. And why not? halfway through the first half. 0-0. Luke Williams is used to that. Given away. Swansea with a chance to break. Couldn't quite, Franco, get it behind the fullback. The on-running Ronald. That's a bit of juggling by Matt Grimes and releases it to Timon. This foul on Piet Harris, no card. He's not one to flash the cards, Michael Salisbury. His two previous Swans away games, just two cards shown. Taking the touch to bring it in field, but just showed too much of it. It's cleared away, and it's a chance for the home crowd to start the pantomime boos on Lawrence Figueroa again. It's been superb so far for Swansea this season. Here's Franco. Now, need to see a little more of him in the game. Going to see it with a return ball like that from Franco as Harris scoops the ball up into the air, and underneath it is Matt Grimes. First league meeting between these two sides since April 2005. That was a League Two fixture. It's also a Swansea 1-0 win. Continuing to have good possession, Swansea. Darling. Out to Piet Harris. Grimes angles the ball in. Well, there was enough in there. Franco, Darling, Vipotnik, Ronald coming in on the far side as well. Decent enough ball by Matt Grimes. To Ben Nelson, Glenn Brown. It's really good by Franco. Got in, there wasn't a lot of space in which to work, but he hooked it forward to Vipotnik, who couldn't turn it on then to Ronald. Jimmy coming down. Matt Ingram is on the bench if Cumming is not able to recover. And as that shows, fair to say, he's popped up all over the place. He's had a key part in Swansea's performance so far. Maybe we'd like to see it squeezed forward another 10 yards. Important touches on the D of the penalty area. Owen Dale there taking a drink. He's barely had a touch of the ball up front for Oxford. Jamie Cumming is recovered. Josh Key coming away with the ball, touching it on, it runs past Franco. He definitely didn't like the challenge. And a yellow card for Louis Sibley. First card of the afternoon, 32 minutes showing on the clock. A scoreline starting to get a little bit used to, but signs are there that Swansea should be in front. four shots so far by the visitors. Nothing from the home side. But two of those shots blocked, and therefore nothing deemed to be on target. Both of those shots coming from outside the penalty area. Maybe this will change it. Space. Ronald. Into the box. Wants to go to the byline. Goes to the byline. Gets another Swansea City corner. Their fourth of the game. The referee says the last touch off Ronald, so let's move that counter back to three. Let's see how fit Cumming is now. Still whether he's got enough in his body to kick long. The answer is no, not at the moment. There have been points there for the taking in recent matches for Swansea City. And it looks as though there's 3 points available here this afternoon. Can they find a way through, though? I think if they do score, you will feel the relief, not just in Oxfordshire, but back in South Wales and all around the globe. Off balance, but job done by Lawrence Figueroa. That's a lovely touch by Franco inside the key. Key on to Ronald. Franco. Blocked cross. The band goes stretched and Franco gets in there. Grimes just knocked off the ball, then his footing was gone. Alan Tymon, Piet Harris over on the far side, and it looked as though it was going to go through to him, but Tymon then just delayed long enough to allow Oxford in the form of Peter Chioso to step on to Piet Harris. Does get the ball. Time and low ball in, but not any great conviction in it. Easily cleared away. Just in two minds there, Josh Tymon didn't have the determination to push down the wing and couldn't find a way to thread the ball through to one of his own players. Momentarily put Swansea in danger, but Key sorts it out, and now Ronald into the box, and there's a goal! Zan Vipotnik! It's taken some time for Swansea City to score, not just today, in previous games also, but they are off the mark this afternoon. Oxford 0, Swansea City 1, and the striker gets his second goal for Swansea City. Little fortunate there from Key's ball, but teed up nicely by Ronald. For a striker who many feel has been starved of service up front, that was too much of a gift. Peace Well, I said earlier, the sense of relief. I'm sure you're feeling it. Swansea City in front. Deservedly so on the balance of play. To a psychological turn that will give to the players as well to go on now and hopefully get some more. Potnick's last goal, August the 17th, home game with Preston North End, Swansea winning by 3-0. Given the Swansea defensive record of late, well, you can imagine that them being in front gives Des Buckingham food for thought. A few minutes to be added on. The keeper had a knock early on, or late on I should say, but I mean, probably 3 minutes plus the five showing from the 45. Go on it back. Oxford quickly collecting and shooting from distance, and Vigourou with his first effort to save of the afternoon to go comfortably. I think it was still in when Key got the initial header. Let's see the shot again. Tyler Goodrum. Right foot. Straight at the keeper. Decent height as well. Swansea working it away from that touchline. Grimes clearly pushed by a frustrated Mark Harris. I'm not sure what he can possibly be arguing about. It's a clear foul. Bango's ball comes out to Franco. Franco, well, he caught it with his left foot and he was trying to curl it round the keeper, but the keeper recovered well from having come out and been caught just outside his penalty area. Made a decent save in the end. Didn't quite get outside, got right to the edge of his penalty area, but the save was comfortable enough. It's Oxford certainly looking vulnerable in the full-back positions. The goal coming as a result of a similar ball to that that we've just seen down this right-hand side. Ronald just can't keep that one in. Pitt Harris has found success over on the left-hand side as well, but we are 90 seconds away from 45 minutes being up. Dozen or so jacks at home. If we can't get them to you at half time, we'll read them out in the second half, but we'll try and get them at the tail end of the half time break. Hashtag jacks at home, send your messages via X and we will read some of those out. As I say, good run. Back again on his right foot. Well, it was on its way in, but Harry Darling keeps Swansea's clean sheet. It was curling. I don't think Vigouroux would have got there. Gets it on his right foot. Darling it is. 3 added minutes. Starting with Oxford's first corner. Vigouroux didn't get there. He's looking at the referee, but I don't think there's much wrong there. He may have been blocked a little in his movements. But Ruben Rodriguez got up. I think the keeper should have got that. Of course, hit the crossbar from a flicked corner early on. We have the all important goal, Zan Vipotnik, the goal scorer. And they've got 2 more minutes left to play. Not so much hold on, they may even venture forward and get a second. Over the last couple of minutes, there's been a clear ascendancy in the game from Swansea City, but defending late on. This time the Swansea keeper does play him ahead of Rodriguez. Seconds. I think he'd be relieved of that. There may not be time for Oxford to get downfield following his mistake. He just gave it away. Swansea clearly, from their body language, content with the scoreline now. Still be time. Nope, there isn't. There goes the whistle of Michael Salisbury. It is half time at the Kassam Stadium. And whilst the advantage may be slender, it's an advantage nevertheless. Zan Vipotnik with the only goal on 38 minutes. We'll see it again during the halftime break and some of the other highlights. Ronald crossing from the right-hand side after Oxford failed to clear, and Vipotnik from very close range. Relatively simple tap-in, but when you've gone five games without a goal, well, they all count in big ways. Half-time, Oxford 0, Swansea City 1. There you are, welcome back. Second half coming up in just a couple of minutes. Let's mention some of the people, though, who sent messages through via Jax at Home. Hashtag Jax at Home via X. Every match day we try and give a mention. First in was Dawn Poole. She sent a picture of Ronaldo, the dog, in Swansea City kit. He doesn't want a bone this morning. She says he wants a Swans goal. Well, Ronaldo, the dog, you've got a goal. Swansea 1-0 up at half-time. Great to hear from you, Dawn. John Williams has actually gone to the game and sent a picture via Jax at Home anyway. So he probably won't get to hear the mention, but if you know John, you can let him know that his mention and his picture were shown on Jax at Home. Mark Richards says good morning to all the Global Jax, as always, watching with Laura out there in Glendale, Arizona. Come on, the Jax, he says. Thoughts with you, Mark, and Laura at the moment. Mark T. Dom has joined him this morning. Crisp November morning up in the northwest, and he says nice to see so many of the North Bank Beer Club in the stands. And we, as I said, we've had quite a few pictures of the Swansea crowd. There's some more of them there for you. I'm not sure they were members of the beer club, but nevertheless, some of the Jack Army. Mike from New Jersey out witnessing the dawn of a new day, and he's hoping that the sunrise gives Swansea a fresh start. That sunrise is out in New Jersey, where, as always, Mike is. Mike's got us a goal this afternoon. GWH says, I fancy a 1-0 win today. We're watching at home in cold Swansea. That's the Hopkins family. Gav, Louise, Gracie, Mia, and baby bump Alfie, who is due on the 21st of December. Cameron Moore watching in Norway on a fishing trip. But the storms will not allow them to fish. I want to shout out to Paul, the only one to catch no fish. Karen says happy birthday, Luke Morgan. Swan 1912 says happy birthday to Kevin. And just a couple more before we get started. Stephen and Karis are in Dubai. Stephen Loynton. And getting ready for my daughter's last game of the season in Washington, D.C. That's from Statehood Now. And that's the Mundo Verde Brooklyn girls fifth grade team. Can they get a shout out? And I'm going to have to mention very quickly before we start, Phil Dillon in Queensland, Australia, who will go crazy on the texts to my mobile in the second half if I don't give Phil Dillon a mention. Consider it done, Phil. Let's get 3 points from the second half. We are a good way towards it. We are 1-0 up at the break with Zanfir Potnik's second goal of the season. 45 minutes, hopefully several more Swansea City goals. Just to keep you up to date with the rest of the championship as well. Three games, this being one of them, with UK 12:30 kickoffs. It's Blackburn 0, Sheffield United 1, and it is Stoke 1, Derby County 0. Swansea City playing towards the car park in the second half. Time running out of space. He's in the left back position. We've got Josh Key right back and Harry Darling, Ben Cabango, centre of defence. Behind them, Lawrence Vigouroux. Then we've got Matt Grimes, Gonzalo Franco, and Joe Allen making his first start of the league season. Miles Piatt-Harris wide on the left, Ronald on the right, and Zanfir Potnik, the goal scorer up front. Should Swansea City need to make any changes in the second half? Well, those they have to choose from. Florian Bianchini, Liam Cullen, Amir Govia, Nelson Abbey, Azeem Abdullah, John McLaughlin, Kyle Norton, Nathan Choa on, and the returning Cyrus Christie. Straight away, getting stuck into those possession stats, Swansea City. bar a couple of minutes before the first half. The cameraman in repetitive strain looking to his right. He's going to balance that out hopefully in the second half as they float one in, and it's on the head of Vipotnik. He had Piet Harris behind him, and the two of them seemed as though they needed to give each other a shout. It looked a better ball for Piet Harris, but he almost seemed to have ducked a little. Here's Vipotnik on the left. Gives it off short to Joe Allen, forces Joe to go back. And in fact, Joe, via Timon's ball, almost back on the halfway line to start again for Swansea against an Oxford side that have everybody behind the ball. 4-1, 4-1, Oxford United. Dale, for them, a virtual spectator. There's a ball past Dale out to Piet Harris, pinged to him by Darling. Crimson side to Key, who's spent much of the afternoon coming in from that right-hand touchline. Harris holds up, leaves for Mukekwa. Ball in from the left-hand side. Oh, it was an easy touch. That's a let-off. As Swansea-born Mark Harris scuffs one. By a long, long way, the best chance that Oxford United have had in this game should have been an equaliser. And by Harris's standards, that's an inexplicable miss. He's been having a great season. Timon doesn't need anyone else. He decides to pick out Ronald. Ronald on his right foot. That spins up in the air for a corner. Timon lifts it, far side, headed down by Darling, great save! Vipotnik denied from close range, and coming instinctive reactions keep it Oxford trailing by a goal to nil. Well, the time to think about it, Vipotnik may have put it a little lower, but he did quickly what he needed to do, and the keeper reacted accordingly. In comes the corner. Brings it down in the box. A couple of shouts from the Jack Army. Piet Harris. Attempted cross. Cleared away. Heffron across field for Popnik. Races back to get behind the ball. Space on that left-hand side, and it's pulled too far back. Target Rodriguez, but no chance at all of him getting to it. Back on that side of the field, flag saves Swansea's blushes on this occasion. Just got to tighten up in that right back position, Swansea City. May not all be finger pointed at Josh Key. It may be that he's outnumbered over on that side of the field. To Elliot Moore, played back across to Ben Nelson. Tuesday night, Wick Williams' men are at the Swansea.com. They will entertain Watford, and it's 8 o'clock the kickoff for that one. Ball through, flag up. Tomorrow, Turf Moor, the destination. Burnley against Swansea City. Swansea going to make a double change now, or a single change now. It's certainly been looking as though they may make more than one change in the game, but they're going to bring Joe Allen off, managing his minutes, no doubt. First start of the season. Cullen. Timon. Yes, he keeps it in. Cross from the left-hand side. Well, it was close, but it was definitely in. A couple of whoos and ahs from the crowd. Franco breaks up the move. Piet Harris, well, he has a go. Right-footed, 20, 25 yards the distance. And it whistled past the near post. Coming down well to his right. Still think it might have sneaked in if it had been a foot to the other side. Darling giving Vic Popnik something to chase. It's picked up by Cullen, who's pulled down. Grimes touches it short. And it's fired in. Well, it was on target. decent move across the Tyman. Tyman into the box, left footed, and Swansea fire one in and make the keeper work. During the break, Louis Sibley, who had been booked in the first half, replaced by Idris El Mizouni for the home side. Swansea continuing to have 65% of the possession. Another way. For every minute Oxford have the ball, Swansea pretty much have 2 minutes. So more changes, Mark Harris going off. Through to Vipotnik. Cleared away, picked up, chance, and Franco flashing it with his second attempt. Wide. Four changes by Oxford United, one by Swansea City. It's the goal at the moment from Zan Fitpotnik. It separates the two sides, scored on 38 minutes. Of course, you would probably expect the striker to score. Let's not forget that Oxford-Swansea was the game back in 1995 where the goalkeeper scored. Roger Freestone, the Swansea City goalkeeper, scored from the penalty spot. One of three goals he scored for Swansea City. Had a few problems back in 1995 with regular penalty takers. A couple of people had missed. Roger being Roger said, look, I know I'm the goalkeeper, but I'm a better penalty taker than most of you by the look of it. Give me the opportunity, and they did. Three times from the spot. He found the target. Back in 1995, it was the equaliser. Oxford a goal up. Roger equalised from the spot, and Swansea went on in the closing stages to grab a winner. In terms of wins, At Oxford, there have been six of them from 16 previous games. Sorry, 2004, 1995, twice in 95, 93, 78, 66. He did hear some reviews of the referee's performance by the home supporters there that in any way offended you. We apologise for the words used in their assessments. Nothing we can do about it, unfortunately. That's the nature of microphones in crowds at live sporting occasions. So much was put on the first goal of the game, and Swansea getting a goal. It's really important that they get another one now, because we've seen last week against Millwall, but many times in the Championship, how one's never quite enough. No matter how much you dominate a game, and Swansea have. And even in the early second half, you had the Harris opportunity in the 6-yard box. They could quite easily and should have brought an equaliser. I don't think Miles Pitt Harris can have too many complaints at that being ruled a foul throw. Nice little flick on. That means that Cullen's got space and time, measures his cross into the middle. It's cleared away. It's going to come back towards Cullen, who's happy to let it spin over the touchline for a Swansea City throw. Focused on his options, Matt Grimes. This is just a crowd of players to drop the ball into. Again, the referee thought long and hard about it. It looked as though it was Cabango rather than Franco that got the foul in. Goals in the Championship to tell you about. Sheffield United are now 2-0 up at Blackburn Rovers. And Derby have themselves an equaliser at the Bet365 Stadium. It's an own goal, but they won't mind. It's Stoke City 1, Derby County 1. So we go up six places in the Championship table. And into the top half if they win this afternoon and those other two scores stay the same. However, that wouldn't be for long, because there's a whole host of games kicking off at 3 o'clock that would again move them to a more realistic position. Lovely work. Cullen was looking to play it down the left-hand side, the timer. There was a foul, and again, the referee, he stopped in his mind and thought about nearly every decision he's given this afternoon. Timon, edge of the box, Franco. Aiming for that top corner. Oxford substitutions haven't made a huge impact. If anything, Swansea have had the best of the last 5 or 6 minutes. Let's see if that statement stays the same now from this attack. Into the last quarter of the contest. Touch, Pete Harris, and then see if he's running it. What's the referee going to give there? Is it against the Swansea man? Referee happy with that. He was right there on the spot, looking down at it. Cullen moving forward. Cullen now to the ball to Vipotnik on his right foot. Just four yellow sock legs blocking his path. For the goal scorer for Vipotnik. Well, you'll be delighted with that goal. It may yet prove to be the only one of the game. It may prove to be three vital points for Swansea City. Florian Bianchini, who looked lively as a second-half substitute last weekend against Millwall in the advanced position. I feel there's still plenty of time to get more goals and get a goal himself. Into the centre, suddenly Swansea are open. They may need Vigouroux to make a save. Thankfully they didn't. It's striker struggling with the shot as much as I'm struggling with my words that in the end that effort. Maybe we putting it well wide. Just underlining though the importance of the second goal. It's a really good challenge. The home supporters don't like it. They've not been happy with the officials throughout, but Oxford, they've drawn a lot of games at home this season, but most of their points have come at home. Josh Key crossing, trying to get it into the centre, not able to do so. Bianchini was there waiting to receive. 12 of Oxford's 14 points have come in front of their own supporters. Swansea pushing to double their lead. Stand on the far side wearing their black and white know the importance and the significance of Swansea Seeker get one from this corner. Darling's shirt being held right in front of the referee. He's trying to get through and it's a comfortable one in the end for the keeper. Oh, mistake by Ronald. Heavyweight gets it into the centre, and unfortunately for Oxford, Dane Scarlett couldn't make the contact. Defence to attack. Cullen touches it on. Piet Harris, well, he went on his right foot to try and play it back into the box. Maybe pulling it back with the left may have been a better option, but he gets Swansea City a corner. Block by Matt Grimes. He's had a good game this afternoon, there's no doubt about that. Here it comes. Darling connected, but not really with any definite part of his body. Great ball by the Swansea keeper. Timon brings it down, slots it in. It'll be a corner. Seven of them now for Luke Williams's men. 13 minutes to go. In fact, my maths isn't that good, 14 minutes to go. Timon hits it firmly in, comes back out, fired back in by Ronald, and it's cleared, and Swansea have to get numbers back. They look as though they're the ones moving fastest in the centre to get players back. And indeed down the wings as well. Gonzalo Franco making the interception. Play on, says the referee. Swansea effectively stopped for the free kick. Good decision by the official. Letting the game flow, trying to keep the tempo going, trying to keep the game entertaining. Given the last five matches, I think we're probably less concerned about the entertainment levels now. For the last 13 minutes, I'm more concerned about Swansea City getting over the line and taking all 3 points. Pithouse gets a second chance. He's done well to avoid a yellow card there, Piet Harris. Oxford looking to start a break. Pulls the shirt back, and I think there's many officials who would have shown the card. We haven't got tired yet of booing. Franco and a chance to run. Just too central a ball for Franco to have any chance to get onto it. About to make their last change of the afternoon. Greg Lee on the side of the field. Defender. Franco, in the space to move into. Franco now, shot from Swansea, 2-0. Florian Biancini races to the Swansea supporters. Franco's ball through him, he thanks him for that. And a 2-0, that could be enough for all 3 points. Well, it's his first goal for Swansea City. It comes at a really important time. You can just see the relief from Luke Williams. Frank has had a very determined second half, a disguised left-footed pass. And Biancini, from the angle, puts it across the keeper's body and in. Had the little look up. There wasn't much to aim for. But he found the bottom corner, and it is Oxford nil, Swansea City 2. Well, Greg Lee, who was going to come on at 1-0. They hold off on the substitution at the moment, but any hoped impact by Lee. Somewhat compounded by the goal. Swansea's last away win, 21st of September. They beat Coventry by 2-1. Talk about Swansea's lack of goals, understandably, before today. But they are 8 minutes away from 3 clean sheets in 5 matches. So Ruben Rodriguez, the number 20, goes off. Greg Lee comes on, and as you see, Azeem Abdullahi is about to come on. He's not the only one. Cyrus Christie is back. And Kyle Norton, well, he hasn't gone anywhere. He's a constant in Swansea squads now. So Piet Harris off. Franco's coming off as well in a moment. So mixing it up, Swansea in the closing stages. Go to Darling. So mixing up Swansea now. Getting other players involved. Players like Abdullahi on a big week. Game Tuesday, game Sunday. The squad is going to play its part. So they can have too many complaints. They'll say they had that really golden chance from Harris at 1-0. It's not to look back at the first half in which they struck a crossbar and had other opportunities themselves. And generally, it's been Swansea with 5 efforts on target to Oxford, 1. And 16 shots from Luke Williams' side, who deserved the 3 points. And his determination despite the scoreline and heavy challenges, nothing wrong with them. Each time you get a little glimpse of that car park behind the goal, you see a few more people starting to make their way out. There's a couple of shopping trolleys as well. They've clearly not been to the game, but there's plenty of home fans now starting to make their way out of the Kassam Stadium. Abdullahi onside, steadies himself. And he'd be disappointed as we are with the final ball into the centre. Biancini racing back to the halfway line, commits the foul. Well, I mentioned he looked lively coming off the bench last week. off a goal today. Abdullahi. Well, he's going to keep that one in. Is he going to get a better ball? Well, I thought he let that one go out then. He got there, kept it in, and seemed to then take it over the line. But 2 minutes to go, plus added time. As things stand, it's the scoreline that we wanted. Swansea City leading, and with a cushion of the extra goal. Scarlett, oh, he's pulled one back, and that's why we needed the cushion. Oxford 1, Swansea 2, and with 2 minutes to go, well, it could be more exciting than it needed to be. Not a great deal of expression from Des Buckingham, the Oxford United manager. But inside, he must be thinking, do you know what? We've got half a chance here. 90 seconds plus added time to go. And Swansea, who going back a few years in the FA Cup. 2016 collapsed to lose 3-2 in the FA Cup with one of the last kicks of the ball. Now half a minute plus added time to see this one out. There's to be no clean sheet this afternoon. Official Tom Neild. A smile from Luke Williams at 2-0. There's a lot more anguish on his face at the moment. Stoke back in front, four added minutes here. Stoke 2, Derby 1. They're going to have to dig deep. Swansea made a number of changes in the last 5 or 10 minutes. Oxford did the same. Will Volks. Bowling gets something on it. Whipped in. That was close. Greg Lee. A couple of minutes off the bench. Darling got it away. Volks just whipped it back in. And Lee's got a really good leap. And downfield. Ball goes out in front of the Swansea City supporters. Same way as I did, 11,454. Here this. Kereth from the media department getting a quick camera shot of him over on the far touchline. where he would have had a good sight of that ball going out to play, and he will know that there are two added minutes still to play. It's standing only in the away end at the moment. Nerves kicking in. The post-match reaction from Luke Williams in about an hour and a half or so on the club's website. I'm sure most of you then will, for the next couple of hours, have one eye on all the other scorelines in the championship. Liam Cullen heading into the corner. Cleared away. Out for a Swansea throw. No hurry to take it. Distance is what matters, and Christie gets it. Downfield, Cullen heads into the corner, and there's a pull of a shirt, and that is Ronald winning a free kick. Well, it's as much looking at what happens on the field as looking at that clock in the top left-hand corner now. The 21st, the last time all 3 points were taken. The added time is up. It is added time now. Can't imagine Swansea going to whip this into the box. I think it's going to be going towards that corner flag. Christie to Ronald. Not sure what he was doing there. Fired it at Liam Cullen. It went out of play. Brown puts it over to the touchline. Grimes hooks it away. And it's any moment now the whistle's going to go, and it's in the right part of the field, but it's sent back into the Swansea half. Darling happy to head away. And again. Was there an offside there? I'm not sure. But the officials were totally focused in on it. Yes, they were. And the referee says there won't even be time to take the free kick for offside. Well, what a last 10 or 15 minutes. We didn't expect it to end that way. Swansea City, a goal up in the first half from Zan Fipotnik, his second goal for the club, his first in this particular game. 38 minutes on the clock when that went in. And when Florian Biancini, who you see there on your screen, scored Swansea's second with 10 minutes to go, it looked as though it was going to be a comfortable afternoon. But with 2 minutes of the 90 left, Dane Scarlett pulled one back for Oxford. And with four added minutes then, never really threatened the Swansea goal, Oxford United, but it left us just panicking a little. But the 3 points are Swansea City's. The goal scoring duck is over. It's Watford Tuesday, 8 o'clock UK time. This afternoon, though, it is Oxford United 1, Swansea City 2.